All right, Michelle Glass here. We are finishing up our axial skeleton with this presentation, and all we have left to talk about is the thoracic cage. So let's start with the sternum, which some people will commonly refer to as the breastbone. Now, the sternum is the name for this entire piece of bone. This bone is formed by three what are called ossification centers. So these are three different places where the bone is formed, and those three places then are given specific names. So this top region here is called the manubrium. This part here is called the body. And this extension here is called the xiphoid process. Xiphoid is spelled X-I-P-H-O-I-D, xiphoid. Really, the only other structure to pick out for the bone is this notch at the top of the manubrium, which is called the jugular notch. So you have jugular vein coming from the brain down to the heart. And so the jugular notch is giving a little place in the bone for that jugular vein to come down. You can see attached to the sternum, you have cartilages, and these cartilages are called costal cartilages, which costal means rib. Costal is spelled cost, C-O-S-T-A-L. So the next thing we can look at are the ribs. Now, I am going to ask you to be able to name the different types of ribs. And that's really it. I'm not going to give you an individual rib and ask you to identify which rib it is. What we will see is that you have 12 ribs on each side of your thoracic cage. Now, if we look at our costal cartilages, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that means two of our ribs are not connected to the sternum via costal cartilages. They're not connected to the sternum at all. And so we'll see that that makes them very specific. Now, if we look at the first seven, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the first seven ribs are going to be called true ribs. And also they are called vertebrosternal ribs because they're having a direct connection from the vertebrae to the sternum via those costal cartilages. So let's take a look at the skeleton here. So you can see our rib cage. And here's our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are our vertebrosternal ribs or true ribs. So you can use either name for me. When we're looking at ribs 8, 9, and 10, notice these cartilages come together fusing with that seventh costal cartilage. So these three here, they are called vertebrochondral ribs. So vertebrochondral meaning the attachments from the vertebrae to the cartilage. The cartilage then is fusing to then connect to the sternum. So it's an indirect connection. And then ribs 11, and 12, you can see here, see those? No connection to the sternum at all. These are called your vertebral ribs or your floating ribs. Now all of these here, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, can be called false ribs, where 1 to 7 are called true ribs. So any of those, that terminology is okay.